My dear friends, we do continue Startup Village, and in the next 30 minutes with real examples, we will learn more about the flexibility and the velocity in different areas. Let's give the floor to the speaker, Rodion Цалкин and Антон Захарченко, the Director for Strategy Development of the Cloud Business in MTS. My dear friends, thank you so much. My name is Anton Zakharchenko. I'm Director for Strategic Cloud Business, MTS. My name is Rodion Цалкин. I am responsible for the new branch of MTS business, Container to Container, Head of Container Virtualization. We're going to talk about flexibility and velocity of startup businesses, and we will provide a few examples. Let me provide some background. Before we came here to participate, we discovered very interesting figures. It turned out that 20% of startups shut down in the very first year of their operation. And it's peculiar that the majority of startups are launched with own funds of the founders. And that's so sad, because you lose your own money. That's not the money of an investor or something. It's your own money. So a lot of startups have this negative experience. We, as startups participated in Skolkovo startup. We participated in a huge modern accelerator. And we've seen a lot of colleagues, startups. The spirit of entrepreneurship is something that helps us create new services and develop businesses. But only less than 10% survive to succeed. And the real flourishing business will amount to just a few percent of all the startups. What can help you make a success? Let us tell you our own story. We, as company, some time ago launched our own business. You know, MTS is a huge provider of mobile services, mobile connection. So a few years ago, we launched new areas of operation, and it was kind of experiment to test whether it works or not, to launch something that is totally different from telecom services. And launching one thing and understanding that if it fails, we will not have this area of operation. So we decided to launch it globally, I mean, in all the spheres that were available to us. So Cloud MTS is something that was launched inside MTS and ended up as an infrastructure center that launches further areas, further services, like the AI in MTS, like big data in MTS, SmartMed, and so on. The launch of the service quite often begins with inventing the service, inventing some tips and tricks, and launching the marketing strategy and starting selling. So the most important thing is to reach the implementation. And it begins with the MPV, minimum viable product. And eventually, as you understand that this service is on demand, is wanted, you find out that you need some research resources, you need a storage space for data, and so on. So this is where You will need a specially designated person who will keep who will manage all these data and all this project. You will need a developer. Like the person who will adapt that all to mobile phones or laptops. So you launch a function, you program the product and launch it. This is the usual way of developing, of launching new products as startups. For example, there is a leasing company, car lease company, that dared to join a well-established market of car lease. Those people understood that starting slowly will take a lot of resources and time, and the start-to-market approach will help them to start quickly using a cloud platform. And actually, the figures prove that the company was growing 2.5 times from quarter to quarter, and eventually it has 25 branches all over the country and continues to develop further. This is one of the examples of very quick startups. Another important and very peculiar startup, which is not yet not a startup anymore, I believe. This is Belkacar, one of the first companies in car sharing market, realized very quickly that at the very start of the project they had to process a lot of data, manage and handle a lot of integration modules, store the data in an effective manner, and that was quite challenging. Building the whole infrastructure on their own platform is complicated and expensive. So the company understood that they wouldn't be able to ensure a stable demand. So this resource had to be flexible. If the demand is growing, they need more resource, they need more data, more storage space. And if the demand is falling, that has to be adjusted. This is a very cool example of such companies. They started in many cities and towns, and they've developed further quite successfully, which proves that time to market is a key factor that solves a lot of problems. It is quite clear, transparent, that it has to do with the infrastructure, it has to do with reliable storage space, it has to do with optimizing the costs for IT and development and managing all the staff to ensure the minimum level and make it flexible, make all the services and the resources flexible. However, the most important thing for a startup is number one, and the first thing and the last thing. The first thing is tight market, to scale up and down, to reach the target audience, and leveling the uncertainty. Very rarely the product is independent from the demand and from the economic situation. And most often, this is quite vulnerable and dependent on the outside market, which has resulted in tremendous growth of cloud services used by established companies and startups. And now I'd like to give the floor to Rodion, who is going to talk in detail what kind of instruments can be used. And this is a nice slide for you to understand whether you need a cloud or you don't need a cloud. That depends on the checkup will include how fast you're going to grow, whether your resources are limited, whether the demand is stable, whether the IT component is huge, whether there is a developer, DevOps, and tester on the payroll, and so on. As you do the checkup, you will need to select the cloud provider, depending on SLA, the quality of data, the number of data centers, and so on. Let me give you a couple of tips. The cloud provider should be friendly, adequate, reliable, and available, of course. Furthermore, all the cloud services should establish the necessary level of security. And I'm giving the floor to Rodion, who is going to talk about the speeding up of development. Even the development of applications is becoming cloud-based. Cloud-native approach is a modern approach in development and operating of applications. The breakthrough in this area is using a container. A container has all the set of applications and platforms that allows to unveil an application on any platform to roll out an application for the client and launching it from one space. After that, you will need to manage the applications, and that is done with the help of Kubernetes, an innovative platform for managing containers. It helps you make them identical, sustainable, and reliable. That can be open source, that can be administrated by your own companies, but very often that ends up like that. In fact, Kubernetes is a very complicated product that requires quite a huge team of DevOps that costs quite a lot today. One of the things you can do is address your cloud provider and obtain a container service directly from the cloud. One of the most important things that you need to know about it, that it simplifies the rollout from a few weeks to a couple of hours. We virtualize the virtual machines. We roll out the Kubernetes, Kubernetes, and we unite all the administration behind a very convenient platform, which is very user-friendly. Furthermore, we have plugins and out of the box. Additional functions like the balancing of traffic and means of monitoring. It can be integrated with other services, and the SLA is at 99.9%, which is great. Now, let me show you a couple of slides, a short video about Kubernetes. Now we're going to roll out a small application that will show us GIFs with cats and kittens. We will add the plug in intro, create the cluster. It takes 3 to 5 minutes. Now the cluster is here. You can see the configuration. You can see the nodes, the virtual machines, and download the kubeconfig. We will open it in this program, look at our nodes, and create the deployment with the help of API product. It manages the application. Here we have created that. You can see It being created here. Now we are going to create this service. It's API object that helps us to give access, to get access to the application. Now we are using Ingross, a router that helps us to direct traffic to the application. We're copying the API address from the interface and check that the application is working properly. Great job. We can see GIFs with kids, with cats. And now anyone can see the application. That's it. Now you have made sure that it works, and in terms of the bonuses, we are offering a free of charge test with a lot of resources, and after that test you will get 20% discount.
To get this test, you can scan QR code, you can use my email address. Please write to me, I'll contact you, and we'll discuss how to do it. And now we are ready to answer your questions with Anton. I think that the most interesting part is to answer your questions, or we can describe different cases that we had. The way we launched our Plus TV, it is a streaming platform. It is a streaming platform, and it resolved difficult tasks. The way you decode video, the way you get this video, because we can understand that you can use these platforms from different devices, from your mobile phones, from TVs, from your computers, and we needed this solution that will allow you to use different devices. So we took this data from streaming devices, and the main is that it can be done not just using simple processes, but you can use different solutions for it. So one of the main elements of the cloud is that you can use different tools, and sometimes it is really expensive. You can use these machines, for example, DeepUX. It is available with the cloud, so you can work with a big number of videos, with the big data using neurons. Well, for different tasks, you can use small devices, but to test it, you need to work with big data, and you need to have a very strong computer, a strong machine that will allow you to do this within a short period of time. We talk about time to market. Sure, you can buy small resources, but it will be kind of really not so efficient. So with the cloud, you can use more data and to use it efficiently, to check your hypothesis, so you can understand how to work with it, what are the results you have, whether it is efficient and bring yield. So you can test lots of different things. So if you do it, it is quite possible that you will find the right solution, the most successful solution that will be actually very interesting. So the question, and based on your experience, what is the most difficult part when you use these cloud technologies? Rodion, can you please tell us about it? I feel that the most difficult stage, it is to choose the cloud that you want to work with. Sure, it's more simple with the clouds than with the infrastructure, because you can change them, it is easier. But when you have lots of offerings, local clouds, clouds from foreign companies, it is really difficult to choose. But an advantage is that we build our cloud, we use open standards. So if you use our cloud, you can take your data, you can use different apps, or you can use different suppliers. It is important because sometimes you use one technology and you cannot get rid of it, and it is not what is really important here. Because when you want different tools, you need to be flexible. There is another question. Please share with examples how to use it, what can be launched. Well, all the apps are possible to be launched with this cloud. Most of the requests we have from e-commerce companies, from retail, from online services, and from banks. But generally speaking, it can be used by all companies if you have a high load, if you have the risk of losses, and you can lose some money if something goes wrong. It is important for e-commerce from banks, so this is the best solution for you. Additional question. How do you use this cloud? Well, thank you for IMTS Startups Hub. It is a very interesting activity. We attract different startups. They can work with the IMTS company. They can go through accelerators, and they can access different markets. The markets our company work with, well, Startup Hub, we use cloud providers to provide resources that are necessary for the startups. And soon we will announce our new program with grants, and within this Startup Hub, we will provide these grants for startups so they can implement their solution and they can meet their technical needs. Startup work with the companies who can be interesting for the IMTS company, maybe to expand some of their services, to solve some of the internal solutions. We are looking for the companies who can be part of our group. And we work with a startup who can be separate. So it's not about our main business. It will be a separate event for such companies. We will have our colleagues today, and they will talk about this Startup Hub. I actually want to invite you to look at this program, to listen, because it is a great experience. They launched different startups. They work with local companies, with foreign companies, and my colleagues can share this experience, and they can tell what was successful, what was not successful. So when you launch new services, it is really important to understand the steps which can lead to these mistakes. It is really important. So when we launch these clouds, we did evaluate the market. Sure, it was a little bit later that was in the United States, for example, but our services today are kind of at the same level. Maybe they are not the same scale that they have abroad, but still we can help people and companies. Dear colleagues, I don't see any additional questions. Maybe you can ask anything what is urgent for you, but we can tell about one interesting case. It's not about IT solutions, it's not about apps which are usually launched. In our cloud, we have a company which is a very big industrial company. This is a British American tobacco company. We can see this company in all the countries in the world. They have internal IT processes, they have industrial processes. It is interesting that they streamline all of their processes using clouds. For foreign companies, when they want to develop their internal services, they use different solutions, for example, Microsoft. And for Russian offices, sometimes with the legislation that we have in place, they cannot use external suppliers, and we have one solution for them. We have Microsoft Region Stack. This is about cloud services based on local platform here in Russia using our data center, which meet our legislation. For British American Tobacco, it's not about internal processes, but we usually follow the manufacturing processes. It was interesting, there was one pilot project, I didn't know about it now, but it was about the quality control. A quality control at the manufacturing, they had special sensors which evaluate products, so there were no mistakes, and all these products met different standards. So it was about special sensors, about neurons, and then at the end, with video cameras, there were images, and this system analyzed whether these products were okay or there is something wrong with these products. And we decrease the number of personnel working on these lines. We do understand that it's quite difficult to evaluate all the products, so we help them to decrease costs. I can see new questions. The question is whether we have any accelerators for startups now. Yes, we have. So at our session, MTS Startup Hub, we will talk about it. They will talk about it in details. They will share the information how these companies are choosing and what are the resources that you can use. Another question, how fast can you get an access to this cloud? It is quite an interesting question. So for startups, they want to receive the services immediately. Sure, sometimes you need to get the information in a longer period of time, but we can provide you all the timelines. This is a long-term plan. Sometimes you need to wait for resources. It is done through the request. You work with our managers. We share it our QR code, so you can use this QR code, you can contact us, and we will tell about this information. The cloud allows you to solve solution, you can upscale your business and your work, and it is the same approach that you have when you work with your infrastructure. But it is more reliable, it meets all the requirements, and it helps you to get an access to your consumers. Well, the cloud is something abstract, but this is the equipment that is placed in data centers, and we work in the major cities in Moscow, Vladivostok, and St. Petersburg. So it is a great capacity that we have. And if you want to access international market, we are present in CIS countries, in Armenia, Belarus. We work with Kazakhstan, so you are welcome. We can provide you different solutions. I don't see any additional questions. Well, we can share our QR codes again. So it is visible for you. You can get our contacts. You can write an email, and you can request all the necessary information that you need. You can also get an access using our website. There are different cases we described. There is the stories of success, and you can get an information about our success. I wish you all the best with your businesses. I do understand that it is really difficult to launch a new startup. I hope that you'll be this 10% of successful startups that will bring yield, and it will be also interesting and important for consumers. I hope that was something that we don't have today. Thank you that you were with us today. Again, we are from MTS company, the head of the container virtualization and the head of the MTS development. So please get our products and develop with us. Have a good day, have a productive work. I hope it will be really useful for you, that you'll be able to develop your startups and will be successful. Thank you. Goodbye.